Well, imagine living in a world completely unlike your everyday life. Oscar-nominated producer Morhan Spurlock does that for a living, and he gives others that same opportunity to walk in other people's shoes for 30 days. I love this. I also just discovered you're very tall.
Oh, yeah. Yes. As I whacked my head on the way into the
set. He walked in here and smashed his head. I thought we'd lost him. But I think he's going to be okay,
it.
John Ridley. I think.
You know, smacking your head, unfortunate. But with this show 30 days,
yeah.
You and you put other people in situations that they haven't been in before. Some of these are a little dangerous. Going to prison, spending 30 days in prison?
I was in prison last season for 30 days. This season I started off in the premiere episode working in a coal mine where I hit my head regularly inside the coal mine, which is only about 5 feet tall. So I'm used to it.
So you're good. You're good.
But you're a family man. I got to ask you, just stepping away from informing the public and giving us an idea of what it's like to be in other cultures. This is dangerous stuff.
I mean,
how does your wife feel about you going out and putting yourself in harm's way?
She wants me to do, you know, she wants me to do like 30 days, like as a flower manufacturer, you know, she wants me to do something a little more calm. You know, in the season finale, which is next Tuesday, you know, it's probably the calmest one I've done. I go back to New Mexico where I work and live on the Navajo Reservation, which, you know, is kind of one of America's dirty little secrets, you know, what's happened on Indian reservations in the United States.
But what is happening on Indian reservations?
Well, I think that we have this image that, you know, that's filled with billionaires. It's the casino billionaires.
Right.
These guys are flush. They're rolling in the dough, and it's just not the case. You know, there are places where it's like a third world country. They don't have electricity, they don't have water. I mean, it's very destitute.
This has me thinking and using my imagination, and I'm wondering, Morhan,
30 days on Morning Joe?
Well,
yes. You would not survive.
No one. Wow, we've had that. I think we've done that. Didn't end well.
Was that the minimum wage episode from season one? Is that what that was?
Yes, actually. I'm wondering what situation we should put Pat Buchanan in.
What would you choose? Oh, I think he could. There's so many great liberal households in America. We could, like, put him right inside
the Osbournes.
The Osborne household somewhere. Yeah, there's a great house where he could live. Maybe like 30 days in the hills, or, you know, on Gossip Girls. He could live with those girls for 30 days.
Oh, Gossip Girls.
Yeah,
what's that awful show where they're inside a house and they're
on CBS?
Because
there's only one awful show on television.
That's right, yeah.
Big Brother, horrendous.
Or he could be in like the Surreal Life. You know,
yes,
30 days
the Surreal Life. All right, we've got good ideas.
These are good ones.
Here's we want to show a clip if we could.
Mm-hmm.
All right, 30 days.
Absolutely.
Here it is.
What's the purpose of a sweat? What does it do?
It cleans me up inside out. Sometimes a patient can't stop vomiting.
It's going to be kind of scary. I'm a little nervous. I don't know what to expect.
You go inside and it's very dark and very hot. You know, the stuff that he gives you helps you purge your system, and so I'm sweating and you're sweating, and I felt terrible.
A little bit survivor-like.
Yeah, but I got to tell you, that was one of the greatest experiences I ever had. It was a sweat lodge where they give you herbs. It's not like it's drugs, but it's natural herbs that make you kind of purge. You know, you basically go in and vomit when you're in there. And it's 100 degrees, and you're like letting all this stuff out of your body. And I walked out of there a whole new person. I mean, I felt like a new man.
But when you say a whole new person, I mean, in terms of some kind of a spiritual experience?
Both.
Or just
I was in there for an hour. Like, you do three bits. Like, I was in for about 20 minutes each time. And I came out, I felt completely stripped. I felt raw. I felt like a blank canvas. You know, I felt like things. I remembered things while I was in the sweat lodge that I hadn't thought about in 20, 30 years. Things
really?
From my childhood. Like these memories come flashing into your head. Things I hadn't thought about that you kind of block off. I mean, it was phenomenal.
Just on a more secular level, what are the kinds of things that you take away from these 30-day episodes? I mean, what kind of things do you learn that surprise you after having done so much of this? What surprises you still?
Well, I mean, I think for me, the greatest thing that I take away from the show is just a real tremendous level of tolerance and understanding. I mean, I think that to do the old adage, you know, of walking a mile in someone else's shoes and seeing the world through someone else's eyes, I mean, I think it really does break down barriers. It gives you a chance to understand people, how they think, how they live. And I think especially in today's society, we need a lot of that.
Where would you put Barack Obama and where would you put John McCain?
Well, couldn't they just switch camps for 30 days? That'd be great.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Now, you also, you have a documentary, Where in the World is Osama Bin Laden?
Yeah, I didn't find him.
You didn't?
I didn't find
him.
We got close.
You're not the only one.
I was going to say, you're in good company.
We got to the border region of Pakistan, like right outside the tribal area, and we were about 50 to 75 miles of where everyone in the region said they thought he was. So, and that was when we turned around.
Wow. Yeah. Morhan Spurlock, where did you get your name?
It's mom, you know. It's like, thank you, mom.
Morhan Spurlock. It's perfect.
Oh, thanks.
Well, 30 days. Now, it airs, it airs 10 p.m. on Tuesdays on FX. I've got to see it. I like it.
Oh,
I like
cool.
it a lot.
Well, thank you very much.
Do you have a favorite one?
My favorite one, I think, of the whole year was a couple weeks ago. It's the animal rights episode. You know, I grew up in West Virginia. I grew up a hunter, you know, hunting for deer and squirrel, rabbits,
you name it.
And so a hunter from North Carolina lives with an animal rights, a PETA family in Los Angeles. And it is one of the finest hours of television ever made.
I like it. Okay, gotta find that one. Morhan Spurlock, love the name, love the concept.
Thank
Great
you.
Job. Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Again, Tuesdays at 10 p.m. on FX.